Hi everyone, and welcome to this tutorial bite for Oxygen Not Included, which is all about biomes. Biomes are the natural areas that spawn in at the start of a game to make up the map. Each map and biome is unique, but biomes are generated from a fixed list of types and will therefore be similar. I'm going to do a quick overview and then go through each biome in more detail. The exact biomes any map has depends on the asteroid or cluster type you choose, and will significantly affect the gameplay. It's difficult to summarise these concisely, but it is simpler in the base game, and here is a table of which biomes are found on each map type. Unfortunately, there is no equivalent for the Spaced Out DLC, and even the wiki is missing some details, but is still the best source of information. If you want to take a closer look at those, then I've linked the wiki page in the description. Jumping back into this map, you can see that the biomes are mostly separated with abyssalite, which forms a natural heat barrier between the biomes. Beware that on some harder maps, these may be missing in key areas, letting dangerous amounts of heat spread. The other thing to mention with biomes is that they only really exist when the map is generated. What I mean by this is that if you strip mine a biome out, then nothing of the biome will remain. So for example, a cold biome does not inherently generate cold. It simply spawns in that way. Being able to recognise the biomes at a glance will really help you plan as you explore the map. And that's all there really is to know about biomes in general, so I'm now going to have a look at them in more detail. For each one, I'll show the full list of gases, liquids, solids, critters, and plants found in them at the bottom, as well as their typical temperature. But I'll just talk through the particularly interesting or useful features. Now, three of the most important biomes are the starting biome types: the temperate biome, forest biome, and swampy biome, unique to the Spaced Out DLC. Note that these biomes also have non-starting variants, but every game will start in one of these three. So first up is the temperate or sandstone biome, which is probably the most common starting biome, being part of the Terra asteroid and cluster that most players will begin with. It has dew-friendly temperatures and oxygen, as well as mealwood and bristleberries to grow with the dirt and water. Hatches and shinebugs also spawn here, and muckroot can be found buried. Oxygen generation in this start is easily done with the oxygen diffuser, fed by the natural algae, and coal is available for early power generation. The second starting biome is the forest biome, and has a very different feel to the temperate biome. You'll also find oxygen and water, as well as mealwood and dirt for early food production. Oxygen generation is different here, and is primarily done with oxyferns early on. Pips are also a defining feature of these biomes, along with the arbitrees they eat, meaning wild planting is available from early on. And the final starting biome type is the swampy biome, unique to the Spaced Out DLC. This is quite different to the other two, and is characterised by its polluted water and polluted oxygen. There is also a lot of polluted mud and polluted dirt, which is the main way of generating oxygen, in the sublimation station. For food, the main plant is the bog bucket, which is fed with polluted water. Plug slugs and pacus are the critters found here. Moving on to the rest of the biomes then, this is the marshy biome, but it was commonly called the swamp biome before the introduction of the swampy biome. The most important things found here are thimbleweed to make atmo suits, and gold amalgam to increase the overheat temperature of many machines. Clay can also be found for making ceramic. Beware the slime in this biome, which will be released into the air if dug up, and cause slime lung for unprotected tubes. Next up is the jungle biome, also known as the caustic biome. This is the natural home of the drekos, and includes their preferred chlorine and hydrogen atmosphere, as well as their food plants of balm lilies and pincher peppers. It is a little hot, but still bearable for dupes, and also has useful amounts of coal for power. The frozen, or tundra biome, is arguably one of the more useful biomes, and as the name suggests, is quite cold. It has large amounts of ice and snow, as well as weedworts and anti-entropy thermonullifiers, so many ways to cool your base. The wolframite present can be used to make tungsten and thermium. Sleetweed also grows here, and if left, can provide a good source of sustainable food. Rust biomes are up next, and are also quite cold for dupes. Obviously there is rust found here, as well as squeaky puffs, nosh sprouts and dasher salt vines, and the ethanol and chlorine to go with these. Tide pool or ocean biomes are found in large numbers on the Oceania asteroids. They are full of salt water as well as poker shells and water weeds. Barren biomes are rare and aren't particularly interesting, at least in the base game. They are mostly rock with a few pockets of coal and refined iron at a warm temperature. The Spaced Out DLC does add more plants and critters to combine elements of the forest biome. Oil biomes are interesting though, and are commonly found at the bottom of the map. They are normally too hot for dupes to enter without atmo suits, but contain many useful resources. Diamond is great for window tiles, and both lead and fossil are found in large amounts. Lead is a useful refined metal for cooler applications, and fossil can be crushed into lime to make large amounts of steel. Of course, there is also a lot of oil here, with the oil reservoirs and slicksters that can make more. Do beware the sporkids that release zombie spores in these areas, but dupes will be safe if they're in suits anyway. Volcanic biomes, unsurprisingly, are filled with magma, and commonly have volcanoes, and that is mostly all they are, except for the neutronium and obsidian that contains the magma. This biome commonly forms the molten core of a planetoid. And last up in the base game is the space and regolith biomes, found at the top of the map. There are space exposed tiles that delete liquids and gases, as well as sunlight that comes from space. In the base game, and on the regolith and frozen planetoids in the Spaced Out DLC, meteors will fall on the surface. They bring metals and regolith, adding to the naturally occurring regolith that the shovels found here eat. The rest of the biome is mostly rock. Generally, space biomes spawn very cold, but regolith brought by meteors will heat up a space biome very significantly. So the rest of the biomes are unique to the Spaced Out DLC, and the first of these is the metallic biome. These are quite useful and contain large amounts of metal ore for building, and look quite cool, but aren't very interesting otherwise. The radioactive biome is up next, and is the home of uranium ore and the beaters that can refine it. This biome is very cold, and will also contain solid carbon dioxide and chlorine. Wolframite can be found here in small amounts too. Then, the wasteland biome is home to sweetles and grubgrubs, as well as their sulfur and sucrose foods. The grubfruit plants that they tend to are also found growing here. This biome is generally okay for dupes, with an oxygen atmosphere and friendly temperature. Coming into the final three biomes now, these are all specific to outer planetoids in the Spaced Out DLC. The niobium biome is found on the superconductive planetoid, alongside the volcanic biomes. Much like the volcanic biome, this is home to very hot obsidian and niobium, and the niobium volcano. It's certainly worth coming here for the niobium to make thermium, and I explained how to do this in the tutorial bite for space materials. Another unique biome is the aquatic biome, found on the water planetoid. This describes the entire planetoid really, and is mostly water with islands of rock. At the bottom you will find useful amounts of graphite to turn into fullerene and then supercoolant, as well as lime that can be used for steel production. And finally, there is the moo biome. The home of the gassy moos, there are large amounts of bleachstone and the liquid chlorine to feed gas grass, which is the moo's food source. Natural gas is also found here, and beware the very cold temperatures that form solid carbon dioxide and chlorine. So that is a complete look at all of the biomes in Oxygen Not Included. I hope this was informative, and thanks for watching.